IDE is an integrated development environment for writing code. So Visual Studio is an IDE for the .NET framework. It's the tool that you'll be mostly using when working with C#. Visual Studio offers a lot of capabilities, starting with easing your development process. It highlights syntax, auto-completes code, has suggestions how code can be improved, and shows errors upon compiling your solution. It analyzes code, giving you insight on performance issues you might have. It lets you debug code, pausing a running application, and gives you a watch on how the current application state looks like when your application is paused. You can even modify code while the application is paused, as long as nobody is using it. With Visual Studio, you can write automated tests right away, out of the box, see which tests succeeded and which passed, reasons why they failed, how long they took to run. With Visual Studio, you can collaborate with different people, much like you would collaborate on the same document with Google Docs. You can do the same real-time collaboration with people on the same solution or project. And lastly, Visual Studio offers easy deployment for the artifacts, for the solution that you build, that you made. So it's just a few clicks and you can basically deploy your solution to wherever you want. Visual Studio offers a bunch of workloads, which you can see here. But the workloads we'll be focusing on will be Windows workload. Another common workload is web, but that's outside the scope of our lessons. So we'll be focusing on .NET desktop development as we'll be making a console application. So in order to download and install Visual Studio, first click this button and select Community 2019. Community Edition is edition of Visual Studio meant for individual developers or open source projects. Also for academic users. Basically, if you're a student of any kind, you can work this at any level as much as you want. So we click on this and it will redirect us to another page and run a download. So we click the launcher, the installer right there. And I have already Visual Studio installed, so let it think a bit and run a setup window, more like a launcher window. For me, workload looks slightly different as I already have Visual Studio installed, but if you click modify, you'll pretty much have the same window if you don't have any workload installed. So here you see workloads window, and the workload you want to select is the .NET desktop development workload, as I select it now here. And as you can see, it includes the following, basically all that we want. And optionally you can select those. I suggest just including whatever it offers optionally by default, don't bother, and click install. For me, it's modified, but for you, it will be installed. So after that, you can launch Visual Studio either from the launcher or from the start menu. And we're going to create a new project. Our project is going to be a console application. And you might wonder, how do I find the template that I need? This is the template window. Visual Studio offers you a bunch of templates. And what a template is basically a bunch of related files. consider those files dependencies that you need to have in order to use, in order to develop a certain type of project. So we're going to use filters to ease out finding our application, our template that we want. We're going to create a C# application on Windows, and it's going to be a console application. So by applying those filters, I have filtered out two templates that suit me. We're not going to make a .NET Core application because it's the capabilities it offers are not needed for our case. We don't want a multi-platform application, and we don't want to utilize the newest features it offers. It's simply not useful for us for now. So we're going to make a .NET framework console application because it is easier to work with for starters. So I hit next. I say the project name. And my solution name will be similar to my project name. Basically, this means that this is the folder it's going to be at with the solution, and the solution will create a bunch of projects. Initially, one project, this project. Now I select a .NET framework version. You can select any version as long as it's 4.5 plus, because we might be using features from this and above. And hit create. So it will create in this directory with this project. It creates a project and it opens a Visual Studio with the project loaded. As you can see here, you have your first code file called program.cs with the contents and the project with the dependencies that it needs, as you can see here. And congratulations, you have created your very first console application, your very first .NET project. In the next lesson, we will delve deeper into Visual Studio, into all those menus, into what you see here and there, how to run your code, how to debug your code, and how to build your code and run it outside Visual Studio. So see you in the next lesson.